Alright, people. So, the ban list is here for OCG. And God, this list is so fucking good. Like, as a conservative player, and that's totally surprising because they are a lot more liberal than us in here in the TCG. So that's really surprising to see that they're banning the Dragon Rules. I'm totally surprised about that. I definitely am. You know, they pretty much have the Dragon Rules at everything now. They've had it at 3. They've had it at 2. They've had them at 1, we have them at 1, and now they are banned. I'm assuming that has something to do with a little bit of, dark matter, I'm guessing. And, you know, dark matter's coming out here, so I'm just hoping that maybe, if it's too busted over there in, you know, liberal OCG land, maybe it's a little bit too busted to come over here. So maybe, I'm hoping that maybe they'll do a whole, preemptive strike and go ahead and ban the Dragon Rule before dark matter comes out here. We'll just have to see. And I'm assuming that maybe has to do a little bit of with the new Red Eye support as well. But Dragon Rulers, yep, banned Construct. Wow. All right, Shaddolls, you're dead. You're done. That's it. Put Shaddolls away in OCG. Holy shit. I know a ton of people are upset about this. I don't care. I don't like Shaddolls. Shaddolls, I do not like. So seeing them dead like this, I'm not even batting an eyelash. But taking out Construct is like literally the nail in the coffin. Banning Construct that's pretty much it. So pretty much all you have to do against Shaddolls is just summon a monster that's stronger than what? 27? Something stronger than anything Shikinaga can get over, and they're pretty much screwed. And block yourself from, Dragon and Squamata. That's pretty much all you have to do. Because literally, you can summon a freaking, a 3,000 beater from the extra deck. They can be like, alright, Shaddoll Fusion? Like, that's fine. Who are you gonna go into? Construct would be able to, attack and use its effect to destroy, but everybody else, no Tashikinaga, not Gristle, not Winda, yep, so this deck pretty much has a problem with authority figures. And just banned Construct. I already had Construct at 1, but banned? That's craziness. That's craziness. So, Shaddolls are pretty much dead in the OCG. Alright, so those are the cards that are banned. Let's go over the cards that are limited to 1. So, newly limited. We got Demok with an Errata. I didn't think that Demok really needed an Errata. I thought that maybe he could come off a ban even without an Errata. But, let's go ahead and look at its Errata because I got it right here. So here we go. Demok. Newly improved Demok with its Errata. So pretty much its effect is you can only use the effect of Dark Magician of Chaos once per turn. All right, so that's fine. So even if you move him from the field and he comes back and you can't loop him like you were able to do in the past with Demok coming back and going and coming back and going and grabbing multiple spells. So you can only use the effect of Dark Magician of Chaos once per turn. All right, during the end phase, if this card was normal summoned or special summoned this turn, you could target one spell card in your graveyard and add to your hand. So that's a little bit better. I don't mind that Errata, that you get your spell card at the end phase, so you don't get just grab it back immediately. I think that's actually pretty decent. So let's say, for example, if it came out here in the TCG now, if you went ahead and special summoned Demok and you grab back that Regeki, you can't just go, all right, Regeki, and, hit me for 28. You're not getting that to the end phase. I was actually thinking about Demok coming back here in the TCG, and a lot of people predicting this, and I think that this whole end phase thing is actually pretty good, because I was worried about Infernoids. I think that, being able to go Reasoning, go ahead and excavate a whole bunch, hit the Demok, special summon the Demok, go ahead and grab you back that Reasoning, activate Reasoning again, and continue excavating, except now you got a 28 beater on the field. I thought that was a little bit crazy, but now you can kind of still do that, but at least it's a turn slower. So you gotta go Reasoning, mill a whole bunch, summon Demok, grab you back to Reasoning. And then during the end phase, Demok grab you back to Reasoning. So it's a little bit slower, but I think that's a justifiable change. That's not too bad. Then, similar effects, at the end of damage calculation, discard destroyed an opponent's monster at battle, banish that monster, alright. And last effect, if this card would leave the field, banish it instead. Alright, so, overall, not a terrible change, but, definitely a change in Demok, and I think this one's actually for the better. That's fine. Alright, so Demok coming back with the Errata, so you can see that in the upcoming future. Kuribandit, wow. Kuribandit and Mathematician. I was thinking Kuribandit a while ago, but I was predicting Mathematician a couple lists ago. I said Mathematician to 1. But yeah, both of them to 1. Like, okay, that's interesting. Armageddon Knight is still, at 1, which kind of sucks. You could probably put Armageddon Knight back up, but, Mathematician, I think, was the correct choice. So Mathematician at 1, Armageddon Knight at 1. What else did I have? They got Construct Ban. They got you can see El Shaddoll Fusion at one, Super Poly at one. I'm missing something. But the deck is so hurt. Shaddoll Games at one. The deck is so hurt. Like Shaddoll's, put them away. Hello. All right. To one. Nekroz of Brionac. So, you know, your main searchy guy, go ahead and put Brionac down to one. So, you know, they're just hurting the consistency of Nekroz. Like, I talked about that in one of my videos. I was like, seems like OCG loves to go after the consistency of Nekroz. So, they're going to go ahead and hit Brionac, hit the consistency. All right. But it's an exchange for something. So, you'll see that in upcoming. Next, El Shaddoll Fusion. Wow. So, Construct Ban, El Shaddoll Fusion, or like, what are you El Shaddoll fusioning for if you don't have Construct? Like, I get it, it pushes for OTK, you can push for game. But, you know, if you're not, you know, El Shaddoll fusing for Construct, really, what are you going into? Like, I guess they just wanted to kick Shaddolls in the nuts. They're like, we're done with this deck, fuck this shit, we're done. Like, OCG, I love this deck. I love this deck. I hate Shaddolls. I love this list. This list is just so good. Like, I have no complaints with anything so far. Alright, next. Nekroz Cycle. Alright, that's that Monster Reborn one, right? The ritual one that you summon the ritual monster from your graveyard. Okay, so Nekroz Cycle, you know, there's a ton of debate on which one's the most OP, the Kaleido and the regular one, and the Cycle. So I guess they chose Cycle, so Cycle to one. That's not terrible. I don't mind that. I definitely don't mind that. So, you know, another hit to Nekroz. Next, Saqlifice. Saqlifice to one, that's interesting. I was actually thinking about that. I'm like, if there's any card to hit in Cleese, it would be Saqlifice to one. Saqlifice is just so good of an equip spell. Like, it is just so fucking... It has four good effects. Like, plus 300, good. Can't be short battle, good. When you... it counts as double tribute, good. When it's sent to graveyard, you get to search for a Nekroz monster, good. Like, there is not a single downside to Saqlifice, and... God, it is just so freaking good that I wouldn't be surprised. You know, a ton of people were saying, like, you know, hit Scout. And I was like, I think they would go after Saqlifice first. And I think that's just, you know, a totally justified and fair hit. And the last card, Limited, oh my God. Like, if it's Limited in OCG, where they're liberal as fuck, please, here in TCG, Vanity's Emptiness to one. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. That is what I am talking about. That's what I want. It makes me... shit, this list makes me want to fucking pack up my bags and run over to OCG right now. Because, yes, Vanity's Emptiness to one. Oh, my God. Like, if we don't get that on our list, I'm so crying. Like, TCG Konami, look at their list and take off of their list because their list is good. God, I love this list. I love this list. So, yes, Vanity's Emptiness to one, finally. And think about it. Think about it. Look how liberal they are. They have all the other traps that, you know, at higher numbers. You know, Vanity is still at one. Wow, it's so fucking good. Yes. So, there you go. Those are the limited. Let's go ahead and look at the semi-limited. So, semi-limited, we have Manju. All right, so Manju returns from limited to semi-limited. So instead of, you know, going ahead and hitting the generic ritual support, they're like, you know what, let's hit Nekroz, you know? So they're just kind of amending their mistakes. So they hit Brionic to one, but you still have, instead of one Manju, now you have two Manju. All right. Scout, yes. Yes, Tool slash Scout to two. I think that's a justifiable hit. The Saqlifice to one, Scout to two, I think is a totally fine hit for Cleese. Also, Vanity's Emptiness at one, you know, I think that might give decks a better chance against Cleese, you know? Because... that's pretty good. I must say, those are some justifiable hits to Cleese, and I think that's fine. All right. Wind up Carriers and Mighty to two. All right. So they have three Sharks, three Magician, and two Carriers. So they are pretty much restoring Windups back to almost back to full power. One more Zenmaity, and they're pretty much at full power. But you got to remember, Hunter is banned. So with Hunter being banned, there is no Windup hand loop. So there you go. But yeah, they have Zenmaity at two. We have it at zero. Yeah, I mean, you can clearly see that we are just totally different. And formulated Synchron to 2. Alright, well, we have it at 3, so there you go. I don't even care about that. Alright, so those are the cards that are semi-limited. Let's go to unlimited. So unlimited, we have Archlord Kristya to 3. We have Kristya at 3. Hornet to 3. Okay, I thought maybe Hornet to 2, but Hornet to 3. So that just completely ups the consistency of Inzektors by immense. But, you know, Dragonfly is still at 1. So, but 3 Hornet, that just helps your consistency. Definitely, definitely, definitely. Especially with Mathematician at 1. There you go. So I think it's a fair exchange. You lose 2 Mathematician, but you get 2 Hornet. So there you go. Rooster. You know, we hit Spirit, they hit Rooster, so now Rooster's back at 3, so they have 3 Spirit and 3 Roosters, or 3 Cox or whatever you want to call it, But yeah, they have three again. Just a troll, just a fucking troll. Burner, Lightning, Stream, and Reactan, all unlimited, because the Dragon Rulers, the big Dragon Rulers, the daddies, they're banned. That's hilarious. I hear a ton of people talking like, wouldn't it be funny if they banned the Dragon Rulers and then unlimited the Baby Rulers? They just did. That's hilarious. That's hilarious. Like, these guys don't need to be on the ban list anymore. They're not going to do anything without the big Dragon Rulers. Those are banned. So, yep, there you go. So, unless you want to go ahead and play it in traditional, where you'd have one of each of the Dragon Rulers and three of the Baby Rulers, but yeah, there you go. Senju. They hit Senju down to one on their last list, and I thought that was a little bit extreme. Manju, I can understand. Manju searched for both, but Senju? Senju only searches for the monster, but in Nekro's hands, that is pretty powerful. But I was like, Senju? Really? I'm like, what next? Sonic Bird? Like, nah. I didn't really think so. Manju? Yes. Preparation? Yes. Preparation is still at one, over there. But Senju, I was like, nah, it's not really justified. They can have Senju. So Senju is back up at three, Manju at two, Brionac at one. Unicorn at one, Preparation at one, so no, Nekroz are still hit over there. Alright, Sinister Serpent with this Errata is a fucking piece of crap, so there you go, it's at three, no one cares. Winda is back up to three, so it was Construct at one, Winda at one, now it's Construct banned, Winda at three. Look, even with three Winda, we have three Winda here in TCG, even with three Winda, with no Construct, I just don't see it. I mean, the deck's even falling off here in the TCG, and we have even less restrictions than they do in the OCG, and that deck's already falling off in comparison to, Nekroz and Cleese and Burning Abyss. Of course, they don't have Burning Abyss, but definitely, the deck is just not as strong, and with this, the deck, you can have three Windows all you want, but without Construct, I just don't see it. They have Shi En at three. They have Shi En at three, and they have Smoke Signal. Smoke Signal. No, they have Smoke Signal 3. They have Gateway. Like, that's crazy. They only have one Rota, though. But, yeah, that is crazy. So, six Amarai is coming through. All right. Let's see some of that in OCG. Big Eye to Unlimited. They limited Big Eye. We didn't. Then they put Big Eye to 2. And then now they have Big Eye 3. We have Big Eye at 3, and it ain't doing anything. So, it's fine. You can have 3 Big Eye, They hit Big Eye down to 1 when we separated our list. They hit Big Eye down to 1 during the end of the Dragon... Well, no. The first Dragon Rule era, after Worlds, where we separated our list. They hit Big Eye to 1. We didn't. And, now they're putting Big Eye back up. All right. Monster Gate to 3. I predicted Monster Gate to 2 on the TCG list, but, they might put it up to 3, but I don't think so. I think they're going to take it slow. I think here in the TCG, they'll probably take it slow. They'll probably put it to 2, see what happens, and then put up to 3. I don't think they're just going to go 1 to 3 on Monster Gate like that, especially since how long it's been limited to 1. So, yeah. Temple of the Kings. That card with its new Errata is not the best. It's okay. I'd say it's... I think you can only activate the effect of Temple Kings once per turn, and you only get to activate one trap card from your hand once per turn. So that's pretty much it, the change on Temple of the King. So pretty much all it does is just increase the consistency of it. I you know what? I should probably check. Let me go ahead and check about Temple of the Kings. Temple of the Kings. Yeah, let me see with its Errata. Do they have the Errata? Errata. You should probably type in Errata. Right. Yeah, let me go ahead and see what the Errata is on Temple of Kings. Is it, you can activate one Temple of Kings per turn, or can you activate multiple? Okay, this is just their last list, but do you have any sources for, I really didn't think that I was going to do this. I apologize for my unprofessionalism sitting here doing a video while checking, where is the Errata? Like, I type in Errata, and then it doesn't even pop up. Like, maybe if I, image search it, it'll pop up? No. Is this the Errata? No, that's the old version, isn't it? Control this card can activate trap cards the same turn that they are set. I feel like that's the old version. Where is the freaking Errata for Temple of the Kings? I typed this shit on Google. I'm gonna pause the video until I find it. Alright, I found it on Facebook, so You can only use one Temple of King's effect per turn unless that turn. So even if you have multiple Temples of King, you can only use the effect of Temple of a King once per turn. So you know what? That card can go up to 3 because you can only activate the effect once per turn. So even if you have 3, it's only still 1. So that's fine. And Exchange of the Spirit to 3. You can only activate one exchange period per duel. There you go. So that's the reason why it went up to 3. That's fine too. Alright, so Sinister Serpent. You can only use the effect of Sinister Serpent once per turn. During your standby phase, discard your graveyard, add this card to your hand. During your opponent's end phase, banish one Sinister Serpent. Okay. So I guess it's a little bit more usable with Sinister Serpent at 3. It makes it a little bit more usable, but it's still kind of the butt. So there you go, especially with Mathematician at 1. So there you go. There is OCG's 2015 ban list. I want this list so bad. Like, if half of this list was our list, I would be so happy. This list is... Mwah! I love this list. Like, I have no complaints about anything. Like, there's not very often where I have no complaints about anything on the ban list. But, yeah, no complaints. No complaints at all. Alright, people. So tell me what you guys think about OCG's April 2015 ban list in the comment section below. And I am looking forward to the TCG. I hope they at least take something off of here. You know, there's just a couple moves and I'm just like, yes, yes, yes. And I hope that we follow through, because lately I have a feeling, I just felt like, you know, the our people who worked on TCG list went over there, and the people on OCG came over here, because our lists have just been just straight booty lately while they be getting all the good lists. So I want a good list. I want our April list to be just as good, even better than this list right here, because God, this list is good. All right, so thank you guys for taking the time to listen to my opinion about the April 2015 ban list for OCG, and I'm totally ready and looking forward to seeing what they do for TCG. All right, guys, thanks for watching. We'll be right back.